GPS acquired.
Hello everyone. Gonna shoot a video today in 444 Tango Papa. This is a 2014 Glasair 3. I just bought it about 6 months ago and just been working a few little squawks out of it. Pretty much everything done. Thought I'd give a little demo ride today, show you how it starts up, how it runs, all that good stuff. Take it up to altitude if we have time. We have thunderstorms coming in, so we'll see how that works out. I'll start with the startup sequence. Pretty simple. Extra fully in, prop fully in, throttle all the way in. I already have the avionics on just because I couldn't talk to you if they were off, but we bring the fuel boost on just for about 2 seconds. That's plenty right there. Throttle back to idle cutoff, and then maybe, not idle cutoff, back all the way, and then just in just a little. Where we got our batteries on, we have dual systems here with the automatic cross tie when you start. We turn on the magneto, electronic ignition, props clear, start. So we're started up. Oil pressure coming up, fuel pressure good. And running fine. If you notice, we have an EFIS master warning here, and that's a few reasons. Our oil temperature is below operational, so we got to get that up before that light will go out. And we also have bus 2 low voltage. This has two alternators. One of them is driven off the backside accessory case of the Lycoming IO540 engine. So that, until it gets a little more RPM, that one doesn't make sufficient voltage. It takes about 1,000 RPM for that to work. So the altitude here at where I'm at in Angola, Indiana is 1,000 foot. So I hit barometer here and adjust to 1,000 feet. Our AWOS is out, so I don't have that ability, but put it right on 1,000, that's about right. Pretty good there, so I'll go ahead and turn on my landing light. And since it's getting close to dusk, we'll flip on nav lights. To taxi the airplane, real simple. Oh yeah, by the way, while we're on the ground, we'll just bring back the mixture till it runs a little rough, then in. But it's real simple. It'll steer pretty much. This is a castering nose wheel, but you really don't need the brakes. Just tap them every once in a while if you need to turn. The rudder's actually fairly effective, even on the ground at slower speeds. So while we're taxiing out, just pay attention around us, make sure we don't run off the taxiway or run into another airplane. The thunderstorms are going to be to the north and to the west, going to be good, pretty good southeast, but we'll keep an eye on them. So while I'm doing this, I'll go ahead and put in where we're going to go. We're going to go direct to, this is a GTN 650, select waypoint. We're going to put in K, G, W, B. That's Albany, DeKalb County. Put that in the GPS. And the Glasair is pretty fast even on the ground. I've got it idled all the way back and still have to use the brakes to slow us down a little bit. So, our hydraulic pressure is at 1500, which is perfect. That's what we want. That's what's holding the gear down. And it's actually over center right now. It's not holding it down, but that's good pressure. You know it's working fine. And we'll go ahead and bring our flaps down to halfway. That's what we use for takeoff, is half flaps. And last time I flew it, that was about 2 times ago, I got a G meter down here. Probably can't see it, but it's we pulled 4 Gs. We did a 360 turn at about an 80 degree bank angle, did 4 Gs. And did negative 3/4 of a G maybe. I don't care for the negative G's too much. Okay, come to a stop here. And we can do a pre-run up. I'm gonna close the door. Number one thing you don't wanna do in a Glasair is have the door open. So you always shut it, check front and back, push real hard both sides, make sure it's fully latched, locked, both sides are good, no problem there. So we'll go through our little checklist to start. It's right down here. The builder put it here to remind you, right in front of you. Alternators are on. There's two of them on this plane. Main belt driven on the front, gear driven on the back. Trim set. Well, the trim on the G3X is displayed on the main screen over here. And we want a little bit up trim for takeoff. So just a little bit up trim, about right there. Circuit breakers. And also, we do have trim on another page here. That's on our engine page. Even has a trim function, and we got rudder. We'll go ahead and roll in some right rudder for takeoff. And our aileron trims a little bit to the right, but that's about right in cruise. That's where it needs to be, and it shows the elevator a little bit up, so we're good there. Check our fuel page. We have 39.4 gallons. This plane holds 82.5, which is good for about 1,300 nautical miles. Be perfect for tonight. We got plenty of fuel for tonight. And so we've got good fuel. Trims are set there, so anyway. Trims are set, circuit breakers all in, except for my AOA. I haven't configured it yet. It takes a little bit of work to configure it, so it's not hooked up yet. So we'll work on that later. Avionics are set. We're at the correct altimeter setting. We're going to GWB. Enunciator panel. Well, we got low bus volts too, and that's because we're low RPM, and our oil temperature now is still in the yellow, getting ready to get in the green. Controls free, and correct, feel good. Transponder set to 1200 and set on ground. It's a remote unit run through the G3X. And we do a run-up, and for the run-up what I do, I go to the engine page, and let's see here, kick the fuel off, and what's going to bring up here is I got a full EGT-CHT indicator along with my fuel flow, RPM, and manifold pressure. What we're going to do is we're just going to bring it up to 1700 RPM. You got to have your foot on your brakes on this plane. It'll charge forward. Basic check, we're just going to let it stabilize here at 1700 so the EGT is stabilized. We're going to shut off the electronic ignition first. Get about a 90 RPM drop, and we're getting rises on all the cylinders is what we want. That shows that all the plugs shut off, and it's a later burn on the fuel. Electronic ignition back on, everything recovers, all our EGTs go down. Same for the magneto, except for this time, you only lose about 10 or 20 RPM, because the magneto isn't doing much, because the electronic's so efficient. Get a little rise, but the mag is definitely working, because it ran with the electronic ignition off. Looks good there, we cycle the prop once. Got a drop in RPM, and the oil pressure drop, which is what we're looking for. No sense doing it three or four times. And we pull back, so we're good there. There is no vacuum system in this plane, it's all electronic, so they don't have to check any of that. And the autopilot. Well, we have an autopilot. Let's see, let's just plan on going to 9,500 feet. So what we're going to do in the G3X here is hit altitude pitch. We're going to go to 95, we're going to dial in 9,500, and you can do it from either side. I'm on the pilot side, so I'm going to do that. There's 9,500 foot. And then what you can do is do the same thing here. You go into the TrueTrack autopilot, hit select. It preloads 9,500 foot in because it's reading off the G3X. We hit enter. But it says autopilot off, and the reason being is we're not ready yet. We're just setting it to be ready to go when we take off. So that's a pre-select feature. Okay, so the autopilot's ready to go. Lights, well, we got our landing light, we got our nav light. I'll go ahead and bring on the strobe lights. Props and mixture. Okay, we're going to bring our mixture all the way in. Double check our prop is all the way forward. And we're going to bring on our boost pump. And on this plane, it's like a Piper. You leave the boost pump on for all takeoffs and landings. And you leave it on until you get to altitude, and then after some time. I'll explain later why later. We're going to rotate at 70 knot, positive rate, gear up. I don't care if there's runway left. In this plane, gear up all the time. You get positive rate. It's much more of a safety hazard to leave the gear down than up. So I'll explain that later also. And our flaps will come up at 105 knots. Just double check. We got the fuel on the right tank, which is the fullest tank according to the indicator. Has real good indicator gauges, left, right. No indicator for the header, but that's my reserve. It's 8 gallons. I know it has 8 gallons because it's visually checked and it's full. So we're ready to go. Pretty straightforward. We'll head southeast out of here and Let's see here, we need to change our CDI source to GPS-1. And we'll put in an initial heading of southeast, maybe a 150. Okay, so ready to go, flaps are set. Double check doors again, doors both shut, locked, no problem. Fuel pumps on, extra rich, prop forward.
Tri-State, Stu Ben, 444 Tango Papa, departing runway 24, Tri-State. That'd be runway 5, Tri-State.
Okay. We're a little over 4,000 foot here. So plenty of runway. Just double check again. Only warning light we have is low bus volts, but if I bring the throttle up, you'll see that comes out. So everything's set, ready to go. Got the synthetic vision showing us the runway. So full power coming in slowly. Plane accelerates fairly quickly. 40 knots. And the rudders are very effective, as you can see. I'm over intentionally moving them a lot, so you can see, but there's 70 knots. We pull back on the stick a little bit, floats off the ground nicely, positive rate gear up. Hydro pump comes on, pressure drops. In transition, the gear is fully up. There's 105 knots, flaps coming up. Flaps are fully retracted. We're 120 knots right now. And what we're looking for is about 150 knot climb. So I'm just going to keep this attitude to start. There's 130 knots. And we'll roll it over here a little bit. And we'll head southeast. You climb full power in this plane, full rich, full power, burning 30 gallons an hour right now. Okay? So here we are in the climb. I'm going to set my pitch and my trim before I set the autopilot. So I'm going to set my ailerons first. They're going a little bit to the right. That's set. That's all on the coulee here, left, right, up, down. This pitch is pretty good. So what we can do is we can hit heading roll. We'll do heading for now. Autopilot heading.
Autopilot engaged.
Set autopilot gauge, altitude pitch, and we'll just go vertical speed for now. So we're climbing at 1,500 foot per minute at 155 knots true airspeed, or indicated airspeed. So the airplane now is going to hold this vertical speed of 1,500 foot, basically, which right now is 155 knots. However, as I climb, I may want to change that to an indicated airspeed, because as the air gets thinner, the plane doesn't perform as well, obviously. It won't be able to hold that 1,500 foot per minute and still give you a nice view. You know, your angle of attack will have to increase. So just double check thing. Engine gauges look good. We're 2,700 RPM, 26.6. Oil temperature 184, oil pressure 83. Volts are 14 on each side. Amps good. Looking good. All right. So we're at 3,400 feet, climbing at 152 knots indicated, still doing that 1,500 foot per minute. I'm going to turn the oxygen on. To do that, you just hit here. This has a mountain high built-in oxygen system. And it's a pulse demand, so it's shooting through my cannula here. This is a boom-mounted mic here. Don't know if you can see this. Our mic-style boom mount. And it's pulsing. I have 2,000 PSI of oxygen right now. And we're at 4,000 foot pressure altitude. That agrees 100% with my indicated altitude. So this monitors the pressure altitude. As the pressure altitude goes up, it shoots more oxygen as needed. It's a very nice system, conserves oxygen. I have my own oxygen system that actually makes oxygen for me. But it works really well. So, okay, now as we're climbing, I'm getting full throttle, full prop. I'm going to bring bring the mixture back now as we're climbing. We're going through 4,800 foot right now, or 4,700 foot. I'm going to bring it to about 2,500, or about 1,250 degrees EGT in the climb, and that's about perfect for a full power climb. So we're at 1,250. 550 degrees on the hottest cylinder. Now we're only burning 22 gallons per hour. Now, since we're, again, we're still climbing at 1,500 foot per minute, but our speed has bled off to 147 knots. So what I can do now is hit select, go into 9,500 foot, I agree with that. But I'm going to change it to 145 knots of airspeed is what I want in the climb. So I'm going to hit that. Now the airplane is climbing at 145 knots, and it's going to 9,500 feet. 9,500 feet is listed on here, and I know this is, you can't read this, but it says 9501. And what that means is 9,500 foot, and the 1 means that it's actually going to intercept that altitude when it gets there. So we're at 90, coming up on 5,800 foot right now. We have exactly 145 knots nailed, because the autopilot's climbing at 145, okay? Our pole is a little bit left now, because as we climb, we have less torque with the engine, so I'll just hit a little electric rudder trim in to center the rudder. So that's in. I'll go ahead and kill our landing light. Strobes are on, navs are on, fuel boost is still on, and we want to keep an eye on the fuel. And the reason being is these Glasairs can run hot in the cowl for the fuel. The engine always stays nice and cool. It is quite amazing. But the fuel can run pretty hot, and when it does, the pressure drops. So I'm keeping an eye on the fuel pressure right now, which is 23.5, which is perfect. If I would flip off the fuel boost, however, which I'll do, it'll drop pretty quickly. It's not too bad today. It's about 80 degrees, so it may not be bad. We are holding 21 PSI, but the standard procedure is to leave it on in the climb, help keep the fuel cool, keep the pressure up. So again, 145 knots in the climb. If I wanted to go, I'm just going by heading right now, and if you want, you know, you can just turn the heading bug. The airplane will turn. And well, since we're climbing more, lean out just a little more. So there we are. Auburn's actually is over here. I just put it in just to put it in. The autopilot will track that also. If we can see this. Watching myself fly on my, this is a new VIRB Ultra 30 camera, and I'm watching it on my Galaxy 8, so kind of interesting. So, technology. Okay, we're going through 8,000 feet. We were going to level off at 9,500. Again, the plane flies itself. I'm not doing anything. You know, this airplane's well known for aerobatics, speed, that kind of stuff, but the reason why I bought this plane is for cross country. It's roughly 205 to 210 knots on anywhere from about 9.5 to 14 gallons per hour, depending on your altitude. Its sweet spot is right at about 11,500. That's where you'll burn about 1,000 foot from selected altitude. At 95 or at 11,500, you're going to burn about 11 gallons per hour, 10.8 to 11, and you're going to do about 207 knots. At 15,000, it's 200 knots on about 900 or 9.5 gallons per hour. So effectively, you go 1,400 miles on that kind of fuel burn, and it is quite amazing airplane. It's very comfortable inside, seats are comfortable, legs fit perfect, nice curvature, bend your knees a little, you can put your knees up if you want a little bit to relax, plenty of room, big width in this plane. You're 48 inches wide, and so plenty of room. You're not shoulder to shoulder, a lot of room in this plane. Coming up on 9,200 feet, and we have it set for 95. And we just got the altitude selects in here. And this is warning the altitude's approaching, and this is saying the same thing. This is saying altitude select is kicking in.
Altitude hold mode.
And it just told the autopilot, just said entering altitude hold mode. So as she levels over, there's 9,500. Okay. Looking good. No warning lights, all good. So our airspeed, our indicated airspeed's increasing. We're 157. We're at 9,500. I'm going to bump the trim down just a little because we don't need climb. Doesn't have auto trim. That's one thing that would be nice. However, every plane I've had that's have auto trim has always failed. So, okay, we're at 165 indicated, which is 195 true at this altitude. We're going across the ground at 210 knots right now. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and just back the prop off. You can could leave it at 2700, but it's noisy. So I'm going to bring it back. I'll bring it back to about 2450. So right there is 2440. Just a little twist here. There's 2550. I'm going to leave it full throttle. Then I'm going to go back to the lean page here on our scanner. I'm going to bring back the mixture. We're currently at 19.1 gallons per hour. There's 16 gallons an hour, 15 gallons an hour. Now I'm going to slow down a little bit. I'm going to watch these EGTs peak. They're currently green. They'll turn blue when they're lean a peak. So I'm just going to keep turning it. 13.9, 6, 13.4, 13. About 12.8 is where we're going to peak probably at this altitude, but we'll see. Initial peak, yep. There's number 2 at 12.8. There's number 6. We're at 12.5. And I need to put gammies in this plane to get the spread closer, but it runs pretty good lean a peak, but I want them closer. 12.3. So 12.3 was full, so I got a half gallon spread between full peak, or the first peak and the last peak. So I want to get that closer with some gammies. We'll get that down to 0.2 or 0.3 real easily. So, indicated airspeed 174, true airspeed 204 knots right now. Our ground speed 219 knots. So, again, 205 knot airplane roughly. If I trim it up a little better, I'll get a little more speed. Need a little more left rudder now because we're, of course, not in the climb. So there we are, we're trimmed out. I'm going to kill the autopilot once just to see how well we are in trim.
Autopilot.
Okay, see, right roll when I turn it off. So I'll put in a little bit of right trim. There's the proper trim. Our altitude is fine. So again, I'll just go into heading rolled mode.
Autopilot engaged.
And then autopilot hold. So there we are. Again, 205 knots on 12.3 gallons per hour at this altitude is not too bad. Get it up another couple thousand feet, you'll maintain the same speed on 11 gallons an hour. Take it up to 15,000, you're 9.5 gallons per hour on 200 knots. Now, we've talked about this. Let's talk about what gets you in trouble in this plane a little bit. I'm going to go to my map page, make sure I don't fly in any airspace I shouldn't be in. Got my map on. Alright, so, you're flying this plane, and I assume you can see the, you can see my hand here. I'm going to kill the autopilot.
Autopilot off.
Plane is very, very easy to fly as long as you're not ham-fisted. You can't be ham-fisted. Let me show you why. We're currently level. Watch my hand here if you can. I'm just going to lean on the stick. I just barely put pressure on it right now. I'm just, with my thumb, just push it down. We're at 500 a minute. 1,000 foot a minute. 1,500 foot per minute. Same with going up. Watch this. I'm pulling back with my finger. I'm just barely, it's pressure. I'm not even moving. I don't know if you can see this. I'm not even moving it. 500 foot per minute. 1,000 foot per minute. 2,000 foot per minute. And it just went off the scale. So, this is where you get in trouble. Indicated airspeed of 150, 140. See this? If you're not paying attention this plane, same thing with roll. Not as bad. But here's where people get in trouble. They get the plane like this, and then they roll it over at about 120. They lose control of it. Uh-oh. Now we're upside down. And they try to pull out of it here. You got to level the wings first. And when you do this, our airspeed's going to wrap up very quickly in this plane. 180, 190, 200, 210, 220, 230, 240. See where I'm saying here? So you gotta level the wings first, take your time. We're not even the yellow arc yet at 255 knots indicated. So, when you're up, and you're flying, and you're all fat, dumb, and happy, you're not paying attention, and you end up like this, this is a bad place to be. Don't try to pull out of it here. You go into a spiral. Level the wings. Take your time. Got a huge red or a huge yellow arc on this plane. There's no hurries. Level nice and gently. That was a 2G maneuver there. Nothing. No big deal. I won't roll the plane today just because I have the long wingtips, and it's not much fun to roll with them. It'll roll, but it's kind of boring. If you want to roll it, you use the other wing. Put the other wingtips on. I don't have a parachute on either, which not that it would help any. So anyway. That's a demonstration of what gets you in trouble in this plane, what to stay away from. If You get in a bad position, level the wings first, always. It'll keep you out of a lot of trouble. As far as handling, again, we're doing true airspeed of 216 knots here. We're a little lower, of course, burning more fuel. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to put it into a pretty steep bank. I'll reset the G-meter here. G-meter set. We'll roll it over. Try to hold our altitude. Okay, there's 4G. I know this ain't very graceful. All right, roll out of it. Woo! That wasn't quite 4Gs. I must not be in good shape today. Anyway, it'll turn tight. It'll hold. It has plenty of power to keep you in the turn. If you stay in it long enough, you'll probably take yourself out before you take the plane out. Okay. So here we are coming into the sun. We'll roll back around. Again, look how easy, nice easy forces on this plane. You know, here's a good 60 degree bank. And it's simple. I got two fingers on here. No problems, no issues. Holding altitude. One finger. Very easy to fly. Takes very little rudder input too. Very little rudder input in the turns. So, all right. Well, let's go back to Auburn here. Direct to Auburn. That's that GWB we put in earlier. Okay. Then we'll go ahead and set the autopilot to to go there. We'll put autopilot nav.
Engaged.
It says autopilot engage, and we'll go vertical speed down. Now let's go down at about 500 foot per minute. We put 500 foot in there. Okay. And we're going to select an altitude of 3,000 feet. So I'm going to put 3,000 foot in here in the box. Hit select, so it preloads 3,000, and we're going to do 500 foot per minute. I'm going to bring back the power. We're doing 220 knots true airspeed. I don't think we need to go that fast at this altitude. And since we're here, let's select a procedure. Okay. So we go into the Garmin here, hit procedure, let's do an arrival, oh, not an arrival, approach, and we will do, I'm a little tight for the 9, but let's try it. We're going to do the 9, and we are going to do the, let's do WQ, transition, activate approach. Actually, let's redo that. Let's do procedure, approach, transition, let's do gum cue. There we are. So, autopilot's bringing us down at 500 foot per minute right now. We're currently at 4,900. We need to be down to 3,000. So we're going to head that way. We're going to head down to 3,000. I'm going to look at my fuel here. Main fuel is about, which main fuel is right and left tank. They each are considered main fuel. Header tanks for reserve only, as we talked. They're both about right even. And I can check my fuel on the engine page, look at the fuel totalizer. And the fuel totalizer shows that I have 33.5 gallons remaining. So got plenty of fuel. While we're at it, I can show you a few other neat things. We got the map page here, which also does all your engine instruments on the top. We have our chart that we can bring up. So I have my chart here, my approach plate for Auburn, if I want to use that. And it is geo-reference. This is a range ring. This is our weather, which I have to hook up my GDL-39 yet. I haven't done that. But this is the weather, our range ring where we'll run out of fuel, which is about down in the middle of Birmingham, Alabama. We're currently almost in Michigan, so not bad for 33 gallons of fuel. And so we're humming along here pretty good. This is our terrain page. This is our traffic page. Again, when I hook up my GDL-39, I already have the correct transponder, so we're good there. And then here, you want to listen to some music? put on music. Maybe.
1,000 feet from selected
altitude. Okay, 1,000 from selected altitude. If you, I don't know if you can see these, but we have our Highway in the Sky boxes on.
Right, right.
Oh, there comes our music. Drinky Valley. All right, we're at 3,600 foot, or 195 knots. Now, another neat thing here with this radio, we can put in here this Garmin waypoint info, and well, maybe let's see here, airport frequencies. Well, the Auburn Airport's Unicom is 123, so I tap that, boom, it puts it in standby, and then I flip-flop. There's a 123 dialed in for me. Okay, I'm going to slow us down just a little. We're humming along at 210 knots true. Again, it's descending at 500 foot per minute, but it slowed our descent because it's in
altitude hold.
Because it's anticipating us landing. They're not landing, intercepting. So it's going to intercept at altitude. There we are. Pressure 2450 RPM. We're burning 1100 or 11 and a half gallons per hour. I'll kill the music for a minute. 11 and a half gallons per hour, and we're still true at 193 knots. That's pretty incredible at this altitude. Ground speed happens to be 193 also. Sorry if you're hearing some ticking, that's my transponder. It needs to have a shield, a dome put over it. It's the comm antenna's right next to it, and the comm antenna's picking that up, so if you hear that, my apologies. Okay, double check, everything looks good. Our hottest cylinder's 325, our oil's 190, oil pressure's 78, fuel pressure's 23.3. Good on fuel. I've been on oxygen the whole time. Again, it uses hardly any with this altitude. It increases oxygen with altitude. Down low here, it don't hardly take any, but I figure use it all the time. I generate my own, and I'll talk about that more. It's a DeVilbiss oxygen generator. It actually generates oxygen, compresses it, and fills the tank. It'll fill the tank to about 2200 PSI, which is good for about 30 hours of flying for two people at 10,000 feet. Not too bad. So, again, this makes a great cross-country airplane. Everyone thinks of it for the speed and for the aerobatics, but the efficiency, one of my main trips is from Michigan to Southwest Florida, Fort Myers specifically. It's 950 nautical miles. I can do it nonstop in 4 hours and 30 minutes on 60 gallons of fuel. Find another airplane that'll do that. A Cirrus Turbo, which is not as fast as this airplane, and has to be at 22,000 to even be close to this speed, will burn nearly 100 gallons of fuel and has to have a fuel stop, and it'll be closer to 5.5-6 hours. So, granted, this is two seats, this is experimental, but look what you get for avionics. I get dual PFDs, an MFD, an autopilot is just right on 3,000 foot. It has a budge. It intercepts perfect. It rolls perfect. And if it breaks, it's hundreds of dollars instead of thousands of dollars to fix. So there are so many advantages to the experimental world. Okay. Just double check our hydraulic system's holding tight at 1,500. That's perfect. At Fort Wayne to our left. And if we put up our moving map here, we We have gum cue coming here. That was my initial outer fix. And since this is a WASP box, it's going to cut the corner for me and start our approach early, or start our turn early. And like I said, you probably can't see it, but we're flying through the highway and the sky boxes here, okay? So we're set at 3,000 foot. Coming along at 183 knots. With the power pulled back to about 60, we're about 60% power. Plus, I'm pretty lean a peak now. I'm probably 100 degrees lean a peak. If I go rich a peak, we would gain probably close to 10 knots. But runs fine lean a peak and runs cool lean a peak, so I leave it there. All right. We're 6 miles from Gum 2, which is 2 minutes. Are you generally in this plane? This is my second Glasair. I had one before. I really decked it out. I had the G3 Touch in it, and I sold it. I didn't know what I was thinking. I sold it. But I generally, when I would fly the approaches in that plane, they'd be around, I'd fly them around 160 to 170 knots until I got close to the final, and then I'd back the throttle off. And the reason for that is, A, you have a fast plane, why not fly it fast? It just handles very good at that 150, 160 knots. You get around 120, which 122 is gear speed, especially with the gear down, it just gets a little sloppy. I just don't like that feeling. So I like to fly it as fast as I can. Well, not as fast as I can, but relatively fast in all phases of flight. Another advantage to this airplane over anything else in its class is its ability to descend fast. The yellow arc starts at 256 knots indicated. Well, I mean, you about got to be downhill. And what's great about that, and by the way, it's starting its turn by itself. Cut the corner here. I'll range that in a little bit, see if you can see it. But it's cutting its corner here. We can bring that up here, too. But, yeah, like I said, you come in fast. The advantage of this plane, let's say you've got bumpy skies below you and you want to be in those bumps in a minimal amount of time during your flying. You stay at 12,000 foot to within 12 miles of the airport. And then you just pull the throttle back and come down at 260, 270, 280 indicated. Red line don't start till 294. So you can literally come down at 280 indicated, no problem at all. So we're doing pretty well here. I'm going to go ahead and go into autopilot approach mode. So I've selected approach, so it should pick up the glide path here. This is a WASP approach. We're coming around here. And the autopilot's doing it all. I'm not doing anything, I'm just long for the ride. And our right fuel tank's a little lower, less than our left, so I'm gonna go ahead and turn the knobs down here on my left. I'm just gonna turn the knob to the left, it's that simple. Fuel pump doesn't need to be on. Looks like we might need to be heading back, though. I'm thinking it's gonna be raining pretty good here in a little bit. We'll keep an eye on that. So as we're coming around, looking good. I'm gonna bring my fuel boost pump on. That's the first thing on the landing checklist. Boost pump on, proper tank, it is. Our gear at 120 and then everything normal after that. Again, the autopilot's gonna hold 120 knots. We'll go to our map page on here. Looking good? Like music? We listen to music. Okay, our glide slope's starting to show up here.
Subscriber, we're on the correct station for your musical emergency.
Now, if I was going to shoot a normal approach, I would have brought back the throttle by now to get it slowed down. I'm not going to do that because we're actually going to head back because I think it's going to be raining here pretty good, pretty quickly. But what it would do, right now it's notice it's the same glide path, so the autopilot's going to intercept and start coming downhill now. So I'm going to knock that off. But it would usually, you know, it would come down and follow that all the way to the ground. We're going to head back. I'll go ahead and richen it up once. We'll run it hard on the way back. Go to 2700 RPM. And we'll go full throttle. And we're going to fuel boost back off. So running it hard like this, when I say hard, it don't hurt it any, but you burn a boatload of fuel, and you're going to see that you don't gain a whole lot of speed. By the way, I'll put direct 2 in here, and we're going to... got to take it out of suspend mode. Here we are. Going to K, A, N. Getting used to running this. A and Q, that's where we're going, enter. So we're at 200 and, 201 knots here. With the long wingtips on this plane, it's not real fast down low. So, you know, we're 203, we're picking up here and we're in a slight climb, I'm not paying much attention. It'll get about 215, 220 knots, that's it. And that's running at full out, full rich, 30 gallons per hour. It's a waste of money. You're much better off, again, to bring it back to 2400 or 2450. I just pick that because it's quiet and smooth at that. And if you want to bring, since we're low, bring back the manifold pressure, 24 inches. 23, 24, right around there. Lean it out, go lean a peak again, and, you know. I'll just lean it out slowly here. There's 13.4. Let's call it 13.2 gallons per hour. We're still doing 201 knots true down low. That isn't too bad at this altitude. Listen to a little music along the way.
The trivia from earlier in the hour, the question is, if you...
And we're going to Snoopang so we can, again...
Years, it's garage. I once every 6 years. Garage is the answer.
We can go waypoint info, airport, frequencies, 120... That's KGWB, I'm sorry. A. A. You don't know my kind in you. N. And where's Q? Q, there we are. Okay, it's frequencies. 123.07, I touch it, it loads it. Flip-flop, it's there, there you go. Look a little dark up here. Take sunglasses off. Again, it's such a great handling plane. I mean, it's just so easy to fly and so much fun. You know, you can pitch it up. It's just so graceful. It doesn't have any bad habits. And with the long wingtips, the stall is so benign. There's nothing to the stall at all. So, I really like the long wingtips. Some people think you're a wimp for flying with the long wing tips. I like the safety factor. With the long wing tips and the gear up, engine out at 105 knots indicated airspeed. This airplane is about 1,000 foot per minute down, 800 to 1,000. With the short tips, it's closer to 2,000. With the gear out, it's about 1,500 foot per minute down at the same speed. And with the short tips, you're closer to 3,000. So that's another thing I was going to tell you safety-wise. When we take off in this plane, again, we get the gear up as soon as possible. The reason's simple. The gear is all the drag in this plane. It's an incredible amount of drag. So you do not want to have the gear down if you lose the engine. And you want it up. The plane accelerates so much faster with the gear up. And worst case scenario, if the engine quits, your engine's toast anyway. What are you going to save? The engine? So what you do is you leave the gear up and you get a little damage on the bottom of the airplane. No big deal. Not a big deal. Same thing with off-airport landings. If you don't have the airport made, you have an engine failure, what have you, you leave the gear up. A lot of the time the nose gear will fold in a field. You don't want the nose gear to fold because the plane goes over, and guess what? You're not getting out of this airplane. It's on its top. Yeah, you might be able to knock your way out, but not very quickly anyway. So, there's the Angola airport. We'll come back around. I guess it ain't as bad as I thought. Yeah, I'll show you how this builds up speed again. 190, 200, 210, and I'm getting descent rate, 220, 230, 240, and we're at 270 across the ground. No big deal though. Just come back out of it. Now we're at pattern altitude. See how easy it is to get to pattern altitude in this plane? All right. We'll take a look at the wind sock.
That's too bad. 14 go pop. Midfield overfly, 2,000 foot.
Okay, coming around. AWOS don't work here, so. The wind. Pretty stagnant either way. But we're going to head into the storm instead of away from it. Get some bumps there. Definitely some weather coming in. So we're slowing down, we're at 179 knots indicated. I'm going to bring back the throttle to 15 inches. I'll bring the mixture rich. Rich mixture. I'm going to bring the prop flow forward just to help slow us down. We're at 169 indicated. We're at 13 inches of manifold pressure, still doing 165 knots. You about almost have to go to idle. So we'll bring our landing light on. There, got our strobe lights on, nav lights on, coming around, fuel's on the proper tank, looking good there. We're still at 160 knots, I'm going to have to bring a lot of power off to slow down. Came in pretty hot though, so I'm at 10 inches, almost pretty much idle. What I'm going to do to cheat here, I'm going to pull back on the stick just a little, again, don't take much force as you can see. There we are, 130 knots, 129, 125, there we are, 122 gear speed. Hydro pump on, comes down, the pressure comes down, pressure builds back up, three green, hydro pump off. I look in the mirror, I can see my gear down. Bring some flaps in, we'll go halfway for now. A little bit of up trim on the coolie hat. Then I'll add just a little bit of power. Double check, props forward, mixture rich. Okay, we're a little high. Show you how fast this plane can come down. There's full flaps.
500.
We're still at 104 knots, 102. Full flaps, gear down. Power off. Oh, there's a little hill on this runway. There we are. A little tough landing there. I have a hard time with that hill. So that was a little harder landing than I usually like to do, but I got a little slow too. I was down to about 67 knots. My descent rate was a little high coming down. Came in a little hot. I was demonstrating how fast the plane will come down. Anyway, I'll let it roll out here a little bit. Bring the flaps up. There we are. Mixture back to lean, a little lean. Keep it from loading up. It's just that easy. last moment. Good 15 knot crosswind there. Swirling too, so made it a little more interesting. And I could have turned my lights on here too. It's got good panel lights and dimmers. So I can bring my switch lights on down here. These are nice. Bring the radio lights on, which will light up the rest of the stuff. And then we got our instruments over here and the chronometer. And again, got to use a little bit of brakes here to make the big turns. You just put rudder input in and then just tap the brakes and it comes right around. Also got some, the builder put some really nice overhead lights in here. Really brightens it up. I don't know if you can see that. He put some in the baggage compartment too. So again, our mixture's lean for the taxi. Our flaps are up. I'm just getting it ready. I'm going to put my trim back for takeoff for next time, so it's ready. I'll go ahead and shut the oxygen off. So the oxygen's off now. You can leave it on. I get a little ventilation in here, open up the door. And we come around, real simple. Castering nose wheels great for this reason right here. Just step on the brake, puts me 90 degrees so I can go backwards, just straighten the nose in. Okay. And the shutdown, it's pretty simple. Left to right to start it, right to left to shut it down. So, again, double check flaps are up. Then I just pull the mixture, drop forward, throttle back. I'll leave the lights on just so you can see the switches, but just go across here, strobe lights off, nav lights off, landing light off, avionics off. Guess I shouldn't have killed avionics till I do the rest here. So avionics are on, I'll shut off the electronic ignition first, the magneto next, and then I got my two batteries here and alternators. Once I kill them, I won't be talking anymore. So hope you enjoyed that. If you have any questions, ask them there on YouTube, be happy to answer them.